When you think about summertime, what comes to your mind? For me, I think about road trips. Growing up, our family knew all about them. There were the 13-hour drives one way to Bible camp in Maine, scenic drives through the mountains of West Virginia to visit family, and the many miles to Myrtle Beach for vacation. No matter where we were going as a family, there were a couple things that always were consistent. Every trip had a start, every trip had a finish. There were a lot of moments in between. The memories that I have from those trips are some of the most cherished things that I will hold on to for the rest of my life. And it's not so much about the destinations or the sights along the way or even the new experiences. It's about the people that I journeyed with, my family. I was never alone. You know, when you think about your life, wouldn't you say it has a similar feel to a road trip? Yes, there's a start, there's a finish, but there are many moments that happen between those two things. There are many highs, there are also many lows. There are celebrations and there are sorrows. And what's tough about this journey is that as you get older, it seems at times that it can get a little bit lonely, right? Maybe some of you live by yourself and you feel alone. Maybe friends and loved ones moved or passed away. Maybe your kids are in college or started a family of their own. Maybe you go to school each day and you feel like no one really notices you. Or maybe you seem to have many people in your life, but deep down, you still have that feeling like no one is there. If that's you, listen to me. You're not the first and you won't be the last to experience those emotions. But also know that this is not what God wants for your life. See, He never intended for you to feel alone. In fact, all throughout the Bible, God reminds us that He is always with us, even when others are not present, or when we experience pain, or when we feel like just giving up. It's easy to say that, but it's also another thing to truly believe it. And that's why we need to continually be reminded of stories and moments throughout Scripture that highlights God's presence in the lives of people who have gone on before us. This summer, I want to invite you to join us each Sunday morning for our summer series called Road Trip, exploring the wonders of the Bible, where we're going to travel to some familiar and unfamiliar stories to show that we are not alone in our journey.